Hello, kiddos. We're going to talk about the evaporator. Again, we're going to break down each component of a basic air conditioning circuit. Remember, there's four basic components: the evaporator, the compressor, the condenser, and the metering device. Remember, the compressor increases pressure to increase temperature. The metering device reduces pressure to reduce the temperature. Basically, we're conditioning the refrigerant so we can absorb it and then we can eject it. And that's why we need a metering device and a compressor to help us condition the refrigerant. Today, I want to talk about how the evaporator works and how we absorb heat from inside the house or inside the business. All right, evaporator. It's a heat net, just like a fish is in a fish net, you know. Its whole purpose is to catch heat. So basically, it's a net. So we bring in the unconditioned air. What I mean by unconditioned air, the air that's obtained heat from the sources within the house, like, for instance, body heat, cooking in the kitchen, products, ripening. There's many sources of heat loads, even heat from outside coming into the home. So the air that's unconditioned, that has not gone through the air conditioner and had some of the heat removed, all right? That's unconditioned air. So unconditioned air gets pulled in through the return somewhere where you have your filter, where you change the filter at. That's the return. So the heat gets pulled into the return and goes, the heat and air gets pulled into the return, goes across the evaporator. As it goes across the evaporator, the air keeps going, but some of the heat gets attached to the evaporator coils. And how does the heat get attached to the evaporator coils? Remember how heat moves? It goes from a high to a low. For instance, 800 degrees, we'll try to make 200 degree, the 200 degree temperature into 800 degrees. So it's going to try to force itself onto the 200. Well, the same way in the unconditioned air, it may be between 7 to 90 degrees or even hotter, whichever it may be. And it's going to go, and the evaporator is 40 degrees. So the unconditioned air, the heat in the unconditioned air is attracted to the 40 degrees evaporator, the coils, right? So as the unconditioned air goes through the evaporator, the 70 to 90 degree temperatures or more is attracted to the evaporator copper coils, which is about 40 degrees right here. So as the air passes through with the heat, some of the heat gets attached to the evaporator, and then the air keeps going and goes back into the house through the registers, the vents, which that's why the vents feel cool and or cold when they're coming out. It's the same air that went in, it's just now it's conditioned. So we have unconditioned air going through the evaporator, giving up some of its heat, and then coming out and going through the vent or the registers, which is conditioned air, which is cooler. So the net has the heat now. All right, now we're going to talk about how that happens. Well, it transfers the heat from the air onto the copper. All right, so the heat transfers from the air, unconditioned air into the from inside the house to the refrigerant by conduction. Heat from the air attaches to the evaporator copper tubing, then the heat in the copper tubing transfers to the refrigerant, which the refrigerant carries the heat to the outside condenser to eject the heat outside. Okay, a good example of what I'm talking about is how you boil water. You take a pan, you fill it up with water, you set it on a stove, you turn on the heat source, whichever type of flame or electric heat. The heat from the elements or the flame transfers into the bottom of the pan. Now the heat is in the bottom of the pan. Now the heat from the bottom of the pan goes into the fluid, the water. Now the water keeps obtaining heat, and as long as you apply heat to the point that when the water gets heated up to a point, it'll boil and become steam. So again, that's conduction, all right? And that's how we absorb heat. The heat gets transferred from the air to the copper tubing. The copper tubing has the heat. Now the heat from the copper tubing gets transferred to the refrigerant. And now the refrigerant has it and takes it to the outside. All right. And as it attaches to the heat attaches to the refrigerant in the evaporator, it evaporates the refrigerant. Remember, coming into the evaporator is a low pressure, low temperature liquid sprayed in like a water nozzle. And as the heat attaches to the liquid refrigerant, it becomes vapor. And as it comes out as a low pressure, low temperature vapor. All right. So again, the evaporator is like a fish net. You throw the net into the water, you drag it, you pull it up, the water goes back into the ocean or the river, and all that's left in the net is the fish. Well, the same way with the evaporator. The unconditioned air goes in, and then the heat from the air is attached to the heat net, and then the air that comes is the same air coming out goes back into the house again, just like how the water goes back into the ocean or a lake when you're using a net to catch fish. Same exact, just the same example. Remember, coming in, it's a low pressure, low temperature liquid refrigerant being sprayed in. Then it comes out as a low pressure, low temperature vapor coming out. So, and basically, the evaporator is about 40 degrees. And it comes out with some heat attached to it, so it's usually about 55 to 60 degrees going into the compressor. All right? So again, how does heat travel? From a high to a low. Like 800 degrees is going to try to make the 200 degrees 800. The 70 to 90 degrees or more is going to try to make the 40-degree evaporator the same temperature, whatever it may be. Okay? And how do we transfer the heat from the air to the refrigerant is through conduction. The heat from the refrigerant, the heat from the air is attached to the evaporator, and then the heat from the evaporator copper tubing goes into the refrigerant, and now the refrigerant carries it to the outside. Hopefully that was a good understanding. If you have any questions, you know how to email me. See you on the flip side.